Let's look at list processing using a simple program. First, a review. Prolog's matching and search. With a program in memory for any query, Prolog searches from the top down using matching on each clause. Part 2 of the matching process can give variable bindings. In this simple example, 2 variable bindings are offered to the user. If the user accepts these, the query succeeds. So, here's the spec of a list processing program to write. It has one argument. If that argument is a list, all the elements are printed to the screen. If the argument is not a list, the predicate fails. It should work like this. Each element is output on a new line. There's no built-in predicate for doing this in Prolog. To write this, think about the base case and the step case. Which one is the easiest? If you thought base case, then good. The empty list is very easy because there is no output. You just need to succeed, so a single fact is enough. Let's give that a comment. Next is the step case, which should process non-empty lists. That can be written using the list constructor function. This expression represents a list with one or more elements. Here is the full rule. It outputs H and then processes T. The predicate in the head of the rule is the same as the final one in the body, so this rule is a recursive step case. Defining predicates in this way makes good free use of Prolog search and matching. Let's see how Prolog runs the program. First, we add numbers to the clauses, and imagine that we have this query with a list of length 3. To prove this goal, Prolog searches from the top of the program. It matches against the head of the rule, giving these variable bindings. These instantiate the rule like this, so the body of the rule gives 2 new goals to prove. Prolog does these in order, so the first is format. This is built in so it succeeds, producing output as a side effect. There's now one write list goal left, but we've reduced the starting length of 3 to 2. This pattern repeats. Searching from the top, successfully matching, and producing new goals. The format succeeds, giving on-screen output, and the argument of the write list goal is one shorter. And once more, searching from the top, matching success, and 2 new goals. The format succeeds with some output, and the argument to write list is now an empty list. With this goal, the search fails to match clause 1. It's an important point. Empty lists cannot be deconstructed. So the search carries on to try other clauses and finds a match in clause 2. Facts succeed without adding goals to the search process. So the program completes successfully. You can see from this tree that the basic process of the search reduces the length of the argument to write list until reaching the empty list.